So we're looking at Beds of Burning. This is the intro. That's it. So it's just three chords. First one is E major. So I've got middle finger, second fret A string, ring finger, second fret D string, pointer finger, first fret G string, and then open B, open E, strum them all. Then we're moving to G. So notice how my middle finger goes first. So you've got middle finger, third fret E, first finger, second fret A, open D, open G, third fret B, and then pinky, third fret E. Or you can do just the ring finger on the bottom. So E to G. Then last chord is A. So you've got first finger, second fret D string. Middle finger, second fret G string, ring finger, second fret B string. If I do that with a backing track, cool. Let me know how you go with that. So the verse and bridge of this song is this riff. Originally played on a bass guitar, but you can play it on the regular guitar. I'll play it a couple times first. Then slowly. So I'm going open E string twice, 6-7 with pointer finger and middle finger. Open again. 5-7. First finger and then either ring finger or pinky. So 0-0-6-7. 0-0-5-7. 0-0-4-5. So that's with pointer finger, middle finger. And then 0-0-3-2. And that's the riff. So 0-0-6-7. 0-0-5-7, 0-0-4-5, yep, 0-0-3-2. Watch the buzzing. So I'm just going to get that backing track I had up before, and I'll show you what that's like. So just before the chorus starts, we've played that riff. Then we go second fret E string 8 times. And then E, G, A, like the intro. I'll just play that little section again. Cool, let me know if you have any questions. So now we're going to look at the chorus. I'll play it first. So the chords, we've got E minor, so that's open E string, first finger, second fret A, middle finger, second fret D, open G, open B, open E. We've got a C, so leave your middle finger where it is, ring finger to third fret A, then first finger on first fret B. Strumming just from the A string. We've got a G, kind of have to shift them all. So middle finger, third fret E, first finger, second fret A, open D, open G, third fret B, third fret E. So we're going first progression, E minor, C, G. Oh, actually, and just before, little disclaimer, you could get away with doing the standard down, down, up, up, down, up strumming through the whole thing. But I'll also show you what he's like really doing. So we got E minor, strumming down, up, down, up, up, down, up. So we'll break it into two parts. Down, up, down, up, up, down, up, up, down, up. Down, up, down, up, up, down, up. And we're gonna do that for the first two chords. So E minor, down, up, down, up, down, up, C. Down, up, down, up, up, down, up. So you can practice running between them. Yeah, just one more time. Down, up, down, up, up, down, up. Down, up, down, up, up, down, up. Now, this G, he's a little bit sneaky. It's in the upstroke. We're changing that to a quick down up, down down up. Yeah, down down up down up. I'll do that slowly. Down down up down up. So he's changed that second upstroke to a quick down up. Down down up down up, up down up. Down down up down up. Up, down, up. Down, down, up, down, up. Up, down, up. And we're going to do that twice. So first progression, E minor, C, G, G. The second time round, E minor to C like before. We're going to D with that sneaky strum for the first bar. Then it's four strums of the D, two strums of like a D sharp diminished. We got first finger, fret one on that D string. Ring finger, fret 2 on the G string, middle finger, frets 1 on the B string, and then pinky, fret 2 on the E string. You can just stick to D if you want, that's why I didn't worry about this chord at the start, but that's what he's actually doing. So we had the D. Cool, so far we got E minor C, G, G, E minor C, D, D, D sharp diminished. I'm pretty sure it's a D sharp diminished, I forget what that shape's called. And then we're basically going to run through all of that again, except you're not doing that chord at all. So the second time around, it's like this. now just down strums. So I might do that with a backing track now to give it some context. So that next section that he's about to go into, I call that the post-chorus. So I'm just going to do it one more time. Let me know how you go with that. So now we're looking at the post chorus. I'll play it first. Yep, I just played the right section. So it's the same strumming as the chorus. Down, up, down, up, up, down, up. So going E minor, C, G, and then when you get to D, it's just all down strums and we're doing 8 of them. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and... I'll just find where that is in the backing track. Here it is now. Back to the verse. So when the post-chorus comes around again after the second chorus, it's the same as what we've already done, except we're going to play it twice. And on the second time, we're going to hold that last D for twice as long. So I'll play it just with the guitar first. Yeah, so now I'll show you what that's like with the track. So then it's going through the chorus again. After this chorus, we're going to have the brass solo. So here's is the brass solo. Oops, I wasn't ready for it. So after the brass solo, we just end on intro twice. So I'll just play the brass solo again and then go out of the song. And that's the whole song. Let me know if you have any questions.